Hello friends, our topic is understanding nested query. Okay, so we are going to understand nested query first. So what is nested query? Nested query is nothing but one query, okay, and there is some condition, okay, and then another query. So one query, condition, another query, this kind of thing is nested query, okay. So we are seeing nested query for finding second largest salary. So what we will write? Select sal, okay, from emp table. This is table name, and we just have to write not sal, we have to write to select max sal, actually, okay, maximum salary from employee, where salary is not equal to, then write again, select max salary from EMP. Okay, so this row will return only one thing. Always remember, aggregate functions like max, minimum, average, count, these return only one single row. Okay, so this will return only the maximum value of the table, and this query where salary not equal to the salary, it will filter the maximum salary from the table, and it will return the rest of the salaries, and this one will select the maximum from rest of the salaries. So this is the concept behind fetching the second largest salary, and so on. You can fetch any kind of thing by nested query. Suppose this is your table, this is your EMP table, and this is, there are two things, salary and employee name, okay, and the salary is 50,000, okay, then 40,000, then 30,000, and the names are A, B and C, okay. And you want to fetch the second largest salary, so first you will fetch the largest salary, okay. So the largest salary will be 50,000, okay, for A, and you will write where salary not equal to, then it will eliminate this option, and it will get this table. The table has salary, employee name, okay, and it will get 40,000, 30,000, BC, and now you will select the maximum salary from this one, and you will have the 40,000, okay, and A. So this is the method of finding second largest salary and writing nested query. First, you, the inner query will execute, it will give you some result, and on that result you will fire some condition and fire your query to find the your appropriate result. So this is the concept of nested query. And always remember one thing that I am showing you. Always remember one thing, that average, as I told you, average, okay, average sum A, max salary A, okay, min salary, these things count, okay, count star, these things always gives one row. So when you are comparing any condition, make sure that you are comparing with one row only, because condition applies on one row, okay, condition does not apply on more than one row. If your inner query is returning more than one row and your outer query wants to get some result in single row, then it will give you the error, okay. Now I am telling you one more thing, that you always have to write select then aggregate function, and it means aggregate function always comes with select part, and all those things which are in group by clause, I will tell you later what is group by and order by in next video. So group by things always comes with select option.